guarantee.
He must have heard me.
Yeah, those words came out of my mouth last week here on Raw. I guaranteed that Shawn Michaels' luck was gonna run out at the Royal Rumble. And boy, did it ever run out. You want a little refresher course, then take a look at this.
Oh, well, last night at the Royal Rumble, Mr. McMahon came down to the ring without that smile on his face. Shawn Michaels was still alive in the Royal, but look!
It's Shane McMahon, a chip off the old block from behind, eliminating the heartbreak kick.
Where Shane McMahon came from, nobody knew. What was he even doing there? But that elimination put the smile on his face.
How about that, Shane O'Mac? Give it up for my boy. Give it up for Shane O'Mac.
He chip off the old block, boys.
That is a prime example of my zero tolerance policy in effect. Now, did I abuse my power a little bit at the Rumble? I guess I have to admit that I did. But then again, as the chairman of this company, what's the sense of having power if you can't abuse it every now and then? You know what I'm saying? I mean, for instance, I could take this entire section over here and have every damn one of you thrown out.
What?
I could throw each and every one of you out of this building. You come out here interrupting me. This is exactly the way all of this started to begin with. What the hell do you want?
What I want is to kick your teeth down your throat.
Oh, I told you. Watch this. This is gonna be good. Don't get ahead of yourself, King.
But I know if I do that, Mr. Zero Tolerance is just gonna fire me.
You damn right I would. I'd fire you on the spot.
Suppose I could do the good Christian thing and turn the other cheek. Just quit. I mean, who needs the hassle? But I know you. Oh, I know you. You'd just sue me for breach of contract.
I'd sue you for every cent you're worth, Shawn Michaels, and I'd get it too. You're damn right.
So that leaves me with my third and final option. Roll back the clock. Give you the HBK of days gone by.
That's the guy. Yeah.
Partying, drinking, pill popping, yeah. That's who you want.
That's who I want.
Oh, no, wait
You're
a minute.
You're damn right.
Yeah, no, and I recognize that looks real good on paper. I know that's popular with some folks, but being popular is not my concern. Whether you like it or not, I love my wife and children, and that is never, ever going to happen.
Well then, if none of that's gonna happen, I guess maybe, John, you're screwed. I mean, you're screwed way worse than Bret Hart was ever screwed. Oh, yeah, you are. I mean, if I wanted to abuse my power a little bit, I'd fire you right here on the spot, but you know what? I don't wanna do that at the moment because I like to think of myself as a good businessman.
You know what? I was hoping you were gonna say that because you are a businessman and it is the businessman in you that I want to appeal to. Vince, think about it. What better business decision could there be than to do things the old-fashioned way? Right here in this very ring. One-on-one, Vince McMahon and the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Whoa! Yeah!
you dare challenge me.
Wait a minute. You're not sure. Whoa, wait a minute. Are you having to think about this? You're not sure. I mean, come on, you're Vincent Kennedy McMahon. You've got more money than God. I mean, you're Vince McMahon. Don't you walk around with the king-sized grapefruits?
Oh, that's what he says.
Don't tell me that at 60 years old, those king-sized grapefruits are all shriveled up. I mean, come on, you're Vince McMahon. You single-handedly took on the U.S. government and brought them to their knees. Surely, you can't be afraid of little old me.
Let me tell you something. I'm not afraid of you, Shawn Michaels. I'm not afraid of the big bad wolf. I'm not afraid of any man alive today. You want an answer? You dare challenge me? No chance in hell.
Whoa, whoa. No chance of a match?
Wait a minute. Who do you think you are? I'll determine if I ever get in the ring again. It'll be on my terms and my conditions. But you know what? All you've done here tonight is piss me off.
It's something you never want
to do. You know what I'm going to allow you to do here? I'm going to allow you to do something never done before in the history of Raw. I'm going to allow you, standing right there, to commit career suicide.
Suicide?
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And all you got to do to commit career suicide is hit me. Come on, John. You hit me, I'd fire you and sue your ass. So, come on, Sean, what do you say? Hit me.
Oh, wait a minute.
Come on.
Wait a minute.
Let me have it. Come on. In the temple. Come on. Hit me in the temple. No, no. Right here. Right in the bottom of the jaw. Come on, Sean. Hit me, damn it. Come on.
Oh, how bad does Shawn Michaels want to hit him?
Come on, Sean. Hit me. Come on. Here, one hand behind my back.
Oh, my gosh.
There's two.
That's got to be tempting for Shawn Michaels.
Come on, hit me, Shawn. Come on. Ah, come on, Shawn. What do I got to do? Get on my knees? Is that what I got to do? Get on my knees, Shawn, huh?
Wait a minute. Look out. Oh! Shane McMahon with a steel chair from behind.
Bring a pretty fair penny, if you ask me.
You're the chairman.
Well, okay, why not?
Shane, real quick. Why have you attacked Shawn Michaels on back-to-back nights?
Because, Todd, it's all about respect. You never disrespect the McMahon family, don't you know that? Bret Hart learned that lesson. Stone Cold Steve Austin learned that lesson. And, Shawn Michaels is learning that lesson.
Come on, Shane, let's go. Let's get out of here. The party is waiting for us at the hotel. Let's go, pal. Let's go. Let's go. Go.
You know, it's a pretty easy lesson to learn.
What?
You don't cross with the McMahon family.
Okay, yeah.
It's not difficult. It's not hard.
Uh-oh. I saw Jim Duggan's board. I need to hear this from you. Next week, there's going to be a special guest referee.
Oh, yeah. It's a championship match. Why not have a special guest referee?
Okay, fine. Well, then, I think the special guest referee should be Lita.
Lita?
Yeah. What do you think? Isn't that great?
Don't you think she might be just a little bit biased in your favor?
Look, Mr. McMahon, isn't there anything I can do so you could see things our way? I'd really love to ref that special match.
Let me get this straight. You're standing there and you're encouraging your girlfriend to come on to... I find this repugnant. I find it repulsive. What the hell kind of a man are you? You'd pimp out your own girlfriend just to gain a favor like this, an advantage in a championship match? You know what? I find qualities like that to be admirable, actually. I mean, when you think about it, I mean, it means that you would do anything to win the WWE Championship.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. You know, but I'm going to allow you the opportunity to perhaps name Lita, because I'm going to put the two of you in a match tonight. The winner of this match will name the guest referee in the championship match next week. So it'll be then tonight, here in Atlanta, it'll be you two in a mixed tag team matchup. You and Lita against, let's see, Maria and the champ, John Cena. Oh, wow.
Chairman Mr. McMahon set up Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels was wide open. Look at this.
John, pick me, come on. Here, one hand behind my back.
Yeah, Vince McMahon baiting Shawn Michaels, begging Shawn to hit him.
Come on, hit me, John.
Yeah, so he
come
can
on.
Fire him and then sue him.
Come on, John. Right. What do I got to do? But get on my knees.
You're right.
Know what I got to do?
It was a
get
setup because
knees,
look
John,
from behind.
Come on.
Never to trust the chairman.
I don't think anybody asked you, actually.
Did you just say nobody ever asked me? I just give you my opinion.
Wait a minute.
Speaking no of the chairman.
Now what?
Doesn't matter now what. When the man comes out, you shut up and you listen.
Hey, everybody, look at Shawn Michaels. Hey, why, Shawn, how you doing? By the way, Shawn, I just came out here to inform you that tonight is your lucky night, Shawn, it really is. And the reason it's your lucky night is because my son, Shane McMahon, is not here tonight. If he were here tonight, if Shane were here, he'd be coming down to that ring and kicking your butt just like he did last week. I was gonna ask Shane to be here, but I changed my mind. And by the way, Shawn, I've changed my mind about something else as well. You know, last week when you were pondering all the things that you might do and your dilemma with me, one of the things you stated was, you know, you might just want to walk out. I mean, walk out on your WWE contract with me. And then you aptly stated, yeah, I know, but if I walk out, Vince, you're going to sue me for breach and take every cent I'm worth. And you know what? You are right. But, you know, I've changed my mind. I have. I'm going to let you walk out on your contract now. I really am. As a matter of fact, I'm going to insist that you walk out on your contract.
What? Huh? Insist?
Next week, in that very ring, we're going to have a Shawn Michaels retirement party. All you got to do is sign on the dotted line right next to my signature. I promise not to sue you. And then, quite frankly, then, Shawn, your career will be over. I mean, that's one of the things you were considering. And by the way, let me just say this. Shut up! Oh. I don't know whether you're considering changing your mind, but I'm not going to allow it. As a matter of fact, your appearance next week at your own retirement party, that's not optional for you. It's mandatory.
What?
Oh, and just one other thing, and that is, since you're going to retire next week, Shawn.
You talk about lack of respect.
Well, this is certainly not going to put the chairman in any better mood, folks.
They're referring to their own city. I can't get over it. They don't like living here in Atlanta either. But in any event, since you're going to retire next week, you know what? What's the matter? You don't want Shawn to retire? Huh. Oh, you're going to retire this next week because, listen, your appearance, it's not optional. Your appearance is definitely mandatory, Sean. And by the way, you're not going to be at WrestleMania. Let's see, so you're not going to be in the main event since you're going to retire. So therefore, you're not even going to be in the tournament. It's my duty to inform you that tonight, you have been replaced.
Oh my God, come on, wait a minute.
Are you kidding me, Shawn Michaels? It has been replaced by Shelton Benjamin. And Shawn Michaels is going to be forced to retire next week? Live. I can't wait.
What?
What's the matter? This isn't exactly the way you envisioned your last night in WWE. You didn't envision it quite like this. I mean, what with five male cheerleaders coming out and cheering you on and you out here surrounded by a bunch of North Carolina hick rednecks?
Oh,
that's not what you envisioned, Sean? Huh? Give me the papers. That's just too damn bad. Sign the papers, Sean. Sit down and sign the papers. Look, I know I was not the easiest guy to deal with, but this is not what I want. I don't want to retire.
Cut his mic. Cut his microphone. Cut it off. Cut it off.
Only one microphone is going to work, Sean, and that's going to be mine from now on.
Man.
Sorry, I'm not going to listen to your crap. I've listened to it too damn long. Now, I'm telling you, sign the papers now.
If Shawn Michaels signs those papers, he's officially no longer a part of the WWE. He's retired.
That's kind of the point, King.
I know that, but...
You're not getting away with this. You don't say no to me, okay? Nobody says no to me. Nobody. I'm Vince McMahon. You don't say no to me.
No.
I can't do it. I know that I said walking away was an option, but it's not. It's not. I love this job.
to walk away from this ring, to walk away walk away from these people would be walking away from one of the greatest joys I have ever known, and I am not gonna do it.
Whoa!
I don't know why you're doing this to me, Vince, but I am not going out this way.
All right, you want to know why I'm doing this? You want to know why? I'm doing this, Sean, because you have something that I want. You have something that I can't have. You have something that money can't buy. You've got that inner peace. Hell, you know who you are. You know what you want. I don't have that, and I want it. Hell, half the time, I don't know who the hell I am. I don't know what I want, except I've got an insatiable appetite for life, and I want more, more, more. Hell, you don't know what it's like being me. You have no idea what it's like being me. I mean, I've got an empire to run, Sean. I've got stockholders to answer to. I've got a film division to get off the ground. I've got sponsors and hundreds of employees to deal with. You don't know the pressure I'm under, Sean. You don't know. You don't know that. You don't know that my life is a nightmare. But you're gonna make that all better. Oh, you're gonna make it so much better, Sean, in just a minute, because you are gonna sign those papers. Yeah, you are. You're definitely gonna sign them, Sean. Because you have to. You see, Sean, I don't like people like you. I hate people like you. I want what you have, and I can't have it.
Sign the damn papers and sign them now.
I've never seen Vince McMahon like this.
Thank you.
situation is going to explode. Whoa. Vince McMahon slapped Shawn Michaels in the face, and now it's papers.
What a huge
shot. Just a little reminder. When you tore up those papers, you opened the floodgates for your own personal hell.
Oh. What the?
Man, you want to see us?
Vince, what?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I sure did. Look, guys, you saw the way that Shawn Michaels disrespected me last week, right?
Yes, yeah, we
did. Well, he disrespected all five of you. He disrespected the Spirit Squad, didn't he?
Yes, he did. Yeah,
right.
Yes.
Wow! About it, huh? What do you want to do about it?
What do you want to do about it?
I'll tell you what you're going to do about it. Okay. I'm going to take four of you. You're going to make your debut tonight on Raw.
Ah! Yeah!
Who are members of the Spirit Squad against? One. Shawn Michaels.
Oh, my God. No.
Dan, you are...
Kenny!
Yeah.
Johnny! Mikey! Nick!
As you four against Shawn Michaels.
Mitch.
Yeah, well, Mitch, I get it, but look, four-on-one is fair. I mean, five-on-one, that's a little overkill, don't you think? Come on, guys, best of luck to you.
Spirit Squad, y'all do it for me and the Spirit Squad, okay?
Got you.
Ready? One, two, three, Spirit Squad!
Yeah, that's the spirit.
Come on, King. You gotta admit, their debut on Raw, they look great. Admit it, King.
Well, I'll say that so far, I'm a little bit impressed.
Lightning fast swinging neck breaker buys HBK a few moments, but he's got no one to tag out to.
I mean, what do you expect, Coach? It's one man against four.
And Mikey's going to make the tag. Back to Kenny.
Here comes Kenny.
Kenny going up top.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at him. Oh, man, what an ovation.
Did that feel like Kenny?
Well, the elevation was great, but I think the hang time was too long.
Oh, I think I saw a flame shoot. I don't know what. That had to hurt.
Tag back into Mikey.
Oh, they all look like they have springboards in their shoes.
I wouldn't put it past them.
They are amazing athletes.
As is Shawn Michaels for taking on four of them. There's the four from HBK. He's up.
There's a little athleticism for you, Coach. Look at this.
I'll give you that.
Down goes Mikey. Shots all around for the Spirit Squad.
They've arrived in the big time.
Shawn Michaels up top.
Oh!
Drives the elbow right to the heart of Mikey.
And Shawn Michaels has arrived. The megaphone is out. These guys are in trouble now.
Now maybe both of you will start shutting up about four on one. Shawn Michaels seems to be good.
Here's a shot for Mitch.
Get the megaphone out of here. The time to tune up the band.
Mikey, don't turn around, kid.
Oh, yes. Well, the referee calls for the bell because look, all five of the Spirit Squad are in the ring right now. Oh, no, now what?
You gonna make a wish?
Gosh.
Oh, right on that right knee of Shawn Michaels. Guys, I guarantee you that they are doing exactly what Mr. McMahon wants them to do.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised if it's not what Mr. McMahon told them to do.
It's a mugging.
Well,
Cincinnati is not sitting too well with Mr. McMahon, is it?
And you can hear this crowd. They know exactly who that man is now. Marty Jannetty.
I don't know if he's ever shown up at a more opportune time for his former partner, HBK. But he was Johnny on the spot tonight. This was a doctor ordered.
Well, I hope he knows what he's gotten himself into. They may be all smiles now, but...
Yeah, Marty Jannetty's going to be in Mr. McMahon's crosshairs now.
You better believe that.
Actually, there are
the chairman of WWE.
A few more things I would have liked to have said about Eddie Guerrero.
I guess maybe you people thought I'd be angry, all upset with what happened earlier on in the ring when Marty Jannetty, Shawn Michaels' old-time buddy, came out and, well, beat the hell out of Spirit Squad. Well, in a way I was, but quite frankly, I'm not really upset with Marty Jannetty. Quite frankly, I think Marty Jannetty needs to be rewarded. So I'll tell you what I'm going to do. In that very ring, next week here on Raw, I'm going to present a full-time WWE contract to Marty Jannetty.
What? Really?
Oh, that's...
And believe me, Marty deserves it. He really needs this opportunity. I guess many of you don't know that Marty's fallen on hard times over these last couple of years. He really could use that contract. He really wants that contract. So there you have it. Next week, I will personally present to Marty Jannetty his full-time contract. Thank you very much.
Well, I told you Mr. McMahon had a heart, but...
Yeah, he did.
But there is this one thing. And that is that just prior to presenting Marty Jannetty with his full-time contract, Marty will only, he has to do just one thing prior to being a full-time WWE superstar, and that's simply join a club.
Oh, club.
A rather elite club. And of course, that would be the Mr. McMahon Kiss My Ass Club.
Oh,
thank you very much.
I knew.
See you next week.
There was a catch.
You know, last week you looked pretty good out here. I mean, helping your pal out, Shawn Michaels, and fighting with the Spirit Squad. You don't look so good at the moment. I mean, you're not thinking about backing out of this, are you? I mean, let's face it, you really want this job, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Not only do you want this job, Jannetty, let's face it, you need this job, right?
Yes, I do.
Not only do you need this job, quite frankly, I don't think it's any secret, you're flat broke. You're destitute. So you desperately need this job, am I right?
I need this job.
All right then, you shouldn't have that sour puss on your face. You should be very willing to kiss my ass. I can see that you are. Matter of fact, you're no different. You're no different than each and every person in this arena here tonight. And you people are no different than everybody all around the world. Let's face it, you all kiss your boss's ass. Come on. You all kiss ass, admit it. Marty, quite frankly, you're not gonna do anything that they don't do each and every day. So what do you say, let's get on with this. Go ahead and get on your knees.
Ah. This is hard to watch.
Well,
not for me.
Maybe you didn't hear me.
I'm trying to make this as hard on Marty Jannetty as it could possibly be.
I said get on your knees.
All because Marty Jannetty, Shawn Michaels, free.
You want this job or not? Get on your damn knees!
Again, he doesn't have to do it. This McMahon has given him a choice.
Man.
All right. So now we get on with this. I'm just gonna unbuckle this here. Excuse me while I whip this out. All right, so what we have here is... What are you smiling at, Lillian? What we have here is Mr. McMahon's half.
There it is.
Now, you got to admit,
oh, God.
That's a mighty fine-looking ass, isn't it?
Lillian thinks so.
Oh.
Flash bulbs popping everywhere. Matter of fact, that's not just a normal ass. Many of you are saying to yourselves right now, Mr. McMahon, you have a magnificent ass.
Oh, man.
So with that in mind, all right. All right, Marty, go ahead and kiss my magnificent ass. Go ahead. I'll even bend over for you. Here we go. Wait a minute.
Oh, no. Oh, come on.
Those socks.
Move it around a little bit. All right. There it is. Come on, kiss it. Not every day you get to kiss Mr. McMahon's ass. Come on. Get closer. You can do it. Do it.
If somebody's just tuning in, this is Marty Jannetty having to kiss Mr. McMahon's ass.
I said kiss my ass.
A contract here in the WWE.
Just a peck, Marty. Go for it.
Damn it, you kiss my ass now.
A lot of people would love to do this.
You maybe, but not a lot of people. What's he doing?
What? He just said he's not gonna do it.
You're going to refuse to kiss my ass? Some other way. Some other way. All right. Maybe I got a little carried away with this kiss my ass stuff. Maybe there is another way in which you can gain employment here. There's always a plan B. So with that in mind, Chris Masters, come on down here.
Oh, come on.
Break that man's master lock. Now, if you don't know what that is, you've been away for a while. I've got a chair here. You come in, I'll be the referee for this thing. Sit down here in the chair. You don't want to do it my way. Come on, have a seat. He's going to apply what you used to know as a full Nelson, but he calls the master lock. Okay? And if you break the master lock, you get your contract. Fair enough. Okay. All right, just a minute now. I'll be the ref on this. On the count of three, we're going to go. You get your arms up there, and he applies the lock. Come on, bring him up. Get in there, Chris. Come on, make sure you hook it in good. Get your arms up, Jannetty. Lock it in good. You got him locked?
Yep.
On one, two, three.
Can Marty Jannetty break the master lock of the masterpiece, Chris Masters, and win a WWE contract?
I think I would have rather kissed Mr. McMahon's ass. It would have been a lot easier.
This is impossible. Get him down.
No man's ever done this.
What's the fans chanting for Marty Jannetty?
That's it. Break his neck. Break his neck.
Now, come on.
Come on, break it. Hey, damn it, I said break his neck. Break his neck, damn it!
Look at Jannetty fight!
Look at this.
He's gonna break it!
Jannetty's fighting, but...
Oh, come on!
Wait a minute!
Now then, you son of a bitch, I said you were gonna kiss my ass. That's what you're gonna do, whether you like it or not.
Oh, come on.
Hey!
Kiss my ass!
Come on, kiss my ass! Come on!
Come on, don't do this! Kiss it good!
Look at this now.
Come on, get it closer.
Fight it, Marty, fight it.
Come on, Masters.
And here comes Shawn Michaels! Shawn Michaels to the aid of his buddy, Marty Jannetty, just like Marty Jannetty came out and helped Shawn Michaels. And now look at this!
Mr. McMahon literally calling his pants down!
Yes!
What's Shawn Michaels gonna... Easy, Shawn, easy!
Look at Mr. McMahon.
Hey, you think Shawn Michaels would actually do it? He's got a free shot.
Shane McMahon!
Shane McMahon, where did he come from?
It's Shane O'Mac!
He was under the damn ring!
Oh, no.
You want to fight a McMahon so bad? Guess what? You may not be able to hear me, but at Saturday night's main event, it's you, one-on-one, in a street fight against my son, Shane.
My God.
Oh, baby. I love it.
Shane versus HBK, one-on-one.
Wait a minute. Shane's gonna add his two cents.
Hang on, wait a minute. My son Shane just had a brilliant idea. I told you, Michaels, you interfere in this, you're gonna have to kiss my ass. That's exactly what's gonna happen. Make him kiss my ass, Shane, come on.
What?
Oh, no. You talk about insult.
Get him up.
To injury.
Bring him over
Shawn
here.
Michaels
pucker
is
his
out
lips
cold.
Now. Pucker his lips. Come on, make him kiss my ass. Come on, make him kiss it. Kiss it, Sean. Kiss it. You like it? Come on. Yeah!
Oh, my God!
Sean looked like he enjoyed that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Michaels has just kissed my ass. And by the way, Sean, you kissed mine, but I'm going to be kicking yours at WrestleMania.
So, you know, I'm watching the Oscars. I'm sure most of you think that the Oscars are a celebration of Hollywood's elite. I have a different point of view. As I was watching the Oscars, I felt that the Oscars are quite simply 3.5 hours of nothing but ass kissing.
That's a good point.
Wait a minute. Don't be talking about Sean kissing my ass that way. Okay? So that was like 3.5 hours of nothing short of ass kissing, but quite frankly, it pales. They puckered up last night at the Oscars, but it pales in comparison to this.
Oh, look at that. On the big screen, no less.
It looks even better in a still shot.
And quite frankly, I'd like to thank Shawn Michaels for the thrill of kissing my ass. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all of the people who, quite frankly, made that possible.
Oh, no, an acceptance speech.
Shane?
Oh, my gosh. Oh,
come on.
This is...
Ah, oh, are you kidding?
There's a lot of people to thank, Joey.
First of all, I'd like to thank the Spirit Squad.
Spirit Squad.
You guys provided the cheer that inspired me to drop my pants. Well done. I'd also like to thank from the bottom of my heart the masterpiece, Chris Masters. Chris, your master lock on Jannetty was nothing short of breathtaking. And as a result, I hereby name Chris Masters and his tag team partner, Carlito, the number one contenders for the World Tag Team Championship, facing Big Show and Kane at WrestleMania.
Man.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. I'd also like to thank Marty Jannetty. Marty, your decision to stick with your convictions and not go through with what I really wanted was nothing short of courageous. And as a result, Marty, You will not be getting a contract here in the WWE, and quite frankly, you will never, ever appear in a WWE ring again. This gets better. My time is not up yet. Most of all, I'd like to thank each and every one of you, the little people. The little people here in this arena and the little people all over the world who continue to kiss your boss's ass each and every day. I'd like to thank you for your complete lack of spine, your willingness to do anything to keep your jobs. It really keeps people like me going. And finally, I'd like to thank my son, Shane. You know, to quote the new Best Picture, Crash, it is that sense of touch. Sometimes we miss that touch so much that we crash into each other just so we can feel something. And in this case, Shane, you had Shawn Michaels' face crash right into my naked ass. And for that, I just wanted to say, I love you, son.
This is one of the best acceptance speeches I've ever heard.
Best supporting son or something.
Brings a tear, really.
Now that I'm sure that many of you, I'm sure, are thinking Shawn Michaels is upset, and he should be. You're probably thinking all the security is out here for my protection or my son Shane's protection. That's not the case. It's here for Shawn Michaels' own protection. And believe me, Shawn Michaels needs protecting. Because when you consider who Shawn Michaels will be facing at WrestleMania, let me just say that Michaels is not facing a normal 60-year-old billionaire. No. He's facing the man who's on, well, he's on the cover of this month's edition of Muscle and Fitness.
Really? That's what I call an unveiling right there.
Now, not only do I have a magnificent ass, I have a magnificent physique to match. And let me just say that if Shawn is contemplating a victory over me at WrestleMania or a victory over my son Shane at Saturday Night Main Event, his chances, well, I would suggest that Shawn Michaels has no chance in hell. Gentlemen, let's make our way right back up to the ramp. Thank you very much. Wait a minute, come on.
Hey, wait a second. Look at the security.
Get him, Shane.
Shawn Michaels, where did he come from?
Shawn Michaels through the crowd, behind the security's back.
Mauled by security.
Get him back.
Well, I'm glad they're here to protect Shawn Michaels.
Well, they are. They are protecting him.
They are.
Protecting him from getting hurt.
Michaels, you got a street fight with my son at Saturday Night Main Event. But guess what? Here tonight, Michaels, you go one-on-one. You go one-on-one with my son, Shane!
Come in.
Hey, Sean, sorry to bother you, but I got a couple questions.
My man, I know you've got a job to do, but negatives on the questions tonight. Stephanie McMahon.
Hi,
Sean. What are you doing here?
I need to talk to you. Todd, can you give us a second, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
Look, before you say anything, I've had enough of you and your family. So I'm asking you right now, please just get out.
I understand that you feel that way, Sean, okay? But I've come in here, there's something I need to get off my chest. You might not want to listen to me, but I'm pregnant. Okay, and that might not mean anything to you, but it means the world to me. And if anybody knows something about changing, it's you. Children change your life, Sean.
And Steph, I hope that they can change yours.
Well, I hope so too. But I've got to start somewhere, and if you don't give me that chance, then maybe my baby and I will never have a chance together. Look, all I wanted to do was come in here and apologize to you on behalf of my brother and my father, because they're not going to. And what they've been doing is wrong. And I'm sorry for everything that I've ever done. I just hope that things work out, and I hope that you accept my apology.
Oh. Hey, Marty. You all right?
Yeah. No, I'm okay. I'm okay. Thank you.
Hey, come on. Here. Come on. Sit down.
Sit down. I'm sorry.
Can I get you something?
Can you get me a water or something? Be more trouble. I'm sorry. I think the baby is just thirsty.
Shawn Michaels unable to stand on his own.
Texas, welcome. Yeah, well, boo all you want, but you know what? Last week, my son Shane beat the holy hell out of Shawn Michaels.
That's true, we just saw it. He beat him officially in a match.
Not only did he beat the holy hell out of him, last week my son Shane beat Shawn Michaels up. And then covered him for the 1, 2, 3. And then insisted that I do the same, which exactly, of course, that's what happened. I beat Shawn Michaels last week myself. Now.
Hey. No, come on. What I love about America, First Amendment. Well, speak your mind.
I can understand. I can understand Shawn Michaels being upset. I can understand that Shawn Michaels being depressed because, quite frankly, he lost to both McMahons in the same night. However, there is no excuse whatsoever for Shawn Michaels' actions and activities after that match was over. I have it on good authority. Matter of fact, I have it documented that after our match, Shawn Michaels later on that very same night became disoriented.
Later on.
Shawn Michaels couldn't even stand up. Michaels was slurring his words. You couldn't understand a word Shawn Michaels was saying. Leading myself and other WWE officials to the only logical conclusion you could possibly come up with. Shawn Michaels is on drugs.
Oh, come on. Unbelievable
accusation.
Probably accurate though.
Please, he's not
Which
serious.
Is why tonight Shawn Michaels is being forced to submit to a public urination test.
What?
A public urination test?
Here?
Gotta get to the bottom of it.
You know, Dad, I have to commend you on this decision because, you know, I for one, I'm concerned. Because I'm supposed to step in this ring this Saturday night against Shawn Michaels himself, and I need to know personally, is this guy clean? Oh.
Ask your sister.
I understand that, Shane. I also understand this. As a result of Shawn Michaels' actions last week, Michaels has besmirched the good reputation of the WWE and everybody in it.
That's a great word and a great point.
Michaels, I demand you come down to this ring right now.
Yeah, let's get this thing going.
Is Shawn Michaels really going to take a public urine test?
Hey, if the chairman says he's going to take it.
We're about to proceed with these tests. Chant his name all you want. He may not be here for much longer because, well, we're about to have this test, John. And if you flunk this test, I just wonder what sort of possible explanation could you have for your actions of last week? What sort of possible explanation do you have for these fans, for your fans all over the world, or for your family for that matter? I just wonder, Sean.
I'll tell you, Sean, I'll tell you exactly what explanation Sean has. Shawn Michaels, you're a liar. You're a hypocrite. And quite frankly, Sean, you're no more than a disgusting, junkie.
Wow.
You're a junkie.
Junkie, come on.
Hey, Shane's just calling it like
well,
he sees
it. Well, if you're a junkie, if you are, these tests will prove it right here in this ring in just a few minutes. And Sean, if you're a junkie, it is my duty to inform you that, quite frankly, you'll be suspended indefinitely without pay. And if you're proven to be a junkie here tonight, then you will automatically forfeit your match to Shane McMahon at Saturday night's main event and forfeit your match to me at WrestleMania.
Well, of course he's going to test positive. Stephanie drugged him just 7 days ago.
Having said all of that, I would like to introduce you, Sean, to Dr. Feldman. Hang on a second.
Watch him.
Dr. Feldman, I'm going to ask you to administer this test. But before you do, may I inspect the cup?
Inspect the cup?
Dr. Feldman, if you would please administer this test. Let's get it on.
You've got to think Mr. McMahon is just trying to humiliate you on Michaels again.
You can't trust a junkie. You can't trust this man. You know he's dishonest. How do we know this is going to be on the up and up? So someone has to supervise this.
Well, all right. Shane has a good point. Not only, doctor, will you administer this test, but you will observe the collection. Oh, man. So if I may have the two of you go into this booth, please, this collection booth, collect a sample. I understand, Sean, that it might be difficult to urinate in front of thousands of people here tonight, as well as millions of people at home on television.
This is just sheer humiliation.
If you would, I've got all night. I don't care if it takes you all night, I've got all night. But right now, the following public service announcement is brought to you by the chairman of World Wrestling Entertainment, Vincent Kennedy McMahon. Kids, I have a lesson for you. If you're a user, you're a loser. Don't wind up like Shawn Michaels. Don't do drugs. Thank you very much. We don't have all night.
They can't yell at the chairman for just doing his job and running this company the way it needs
guys,
to be run.
Don't you think he's trying to humiliate Shawn Michaels with this?
Hey.
Oh, my God. Oh, you really had to go. Whoa. Easy.
Look at Dr. Feldman.
Now, Doc, if you would proceed with your testing and only take a minute or two to prove one way or not whether or not Shawn Michaels has been taking drugs. However, Shane and I were talking before we came out tonight. I was wondering what you might say in a set of circumstances like this, Shawn. I mean, before this test proves you to be positive, would you like to apologize to your family? Or I was just wondering what you might want to say. And, hey, guys, why don't you hand Shawn this mic? Hand him the mic.
You know what, Shawn? There's an old classic saying, and what he should have said is, Dad, just say no.
A lot of good messages right here, guys. A lot of good messages.
You're enjoying this, aren't you? You know, Shane, there's another old classic saying, and it goes a little something like this. Doc, it's better to be pissed off than pissed off.
I'm Vince McMahon, chairman of WWE, and this is my son, Shane. Several months ago, Shawn Michaels disrespected me on national television, and I vowed to make Shawn Michaels' life a living hell. And tonight, I will fulfill that promise when my son, Shane, takes on Shawn Michaels in a street fight.
No rules, no restrictions, and no mercy.
Yeah, baby.
So, Vince McMahon is going to make my life a living hell. You're a son. Vince, you want me to sink down to your level? Well, tonight, you just might get it. If I'm going to hell, your son Shane is coming with me. The only difference, I'm coming back.
And his boy, I don't think Mr. McMahon would care if his own son went to hell as long as he beat Shawn Michaels. Again. Shane McMahon using that ladder as a weapon.
Come on, ram it!
And it's completely legal in this match because anything goes. It could be Shawn Michaels.
And that's him do it right there. That
Come on,
could do it right
it.
There, the ladder to the face. How much more can Michaels take? I suspect not. Oh, yes! I suspect a little more.
How does he get past this with that ladder? Run right into Shawn's face by Shane McMahon.
Michaels tried to get his hands up to deflect that ladder, but to no avail. Now Shane McMahon.
That's gonna hurt.
Driving that elbow right into that lower back of Shawn Michaels.
What do you say, Michaels?
Again, Michaels had a several-year hiatus, King, as we all remember, because of back issues. Surfboard applied by Shane McMahon. This situation is as personal as any match going into WrestleMania 2 weeks from now.
Well, Mr. McMahon said that he was going to be sure that Shawn Michaels' life becomes a living hell. But right now, it's just that.
The Crown Prince, Shane McMahon, continues to punish the courageous Shawn Michaels. But does Michaels have enough left in that ravaged body to fight his way back into this match? The progeny of Vince McMahon punishing that right knee posted in the spine of Shawn Michaels. The pain etched on the face of the Heartbreak Kid. And the show may be about ready to stop for Shawn Michaels here tonight.
Well, Mr. McMahon, just grinning, smiling, shouting out those orders as usual at ringside.
Our camera taking right inside the ring, referee Mike Yoda, asking Shawn Michaels if he wants to give it up. And look at that diabolical look of Mr. McMahon on the outside.
Yeah, he's pleading with Shane to make Shawn Michaels give up, but I don't know. Dale, you know Shawn Michaels better than anybody. Do you think he would ever give up in a match this big?
I don't think it's any. I don't think he may pass out. He may be unconscious. Look, and Mr. McMahon is being worried. Where does Michaels get it? Where does Michaels get the courage? And look, Michaels taking a shot at the chairman and the DDT. A massive
DDT by Shane McMahon. The cover is Michaels roll the left shoulder off the canvas.
And I think the doubt is beginning to creep into the mind of Shane McMahon. Can he beat Shawn Michaels in this street fight? What is it going to take? Can it be done?
Shane's diabolical daddy tried to interfere, but to no avail. But again, remember, steel chairs are legal in this street fight. My gosh, this is bedlam here.
Look at this. John, watch your back.
Steel chair in hand. Oh, that's a mighty.
Oh, look at this. Look at that.
The damage done.
Now you got him. Now you got him.
The damage has been done, perhaps once and for all, to Shawn Michaels. How can Michaels withstand this?
I don't know. Look at that. Listen to that impact. And Vince McMahon screaming out, now you got him. Now what? What is garbage can?
Oh, wait a minute. Michaels is defenseless here after being hit in the face with that chair.
Well, it is a street fight. Things you'd find on any street are being used. There's a
Mr. McMahon holding that trash can in the face of Shawn Michaels. Is Shane McMahon going to attempt to go coast to coast here?
Oh, goodness.
His version.
Oh, my gosh!
Shane, HBK move! And the trash can went into the face of the chairman of the WWE.
Right between the eyes with that trash can. Watch this again. Oh my goodness.
Shane McMahon's version of that Terminator intended for Michaels. Instead caught his father. And now it's right hands from both men. The fatigue factor, the pain factor, the bodies have got to be aching. Of both these are... Contenders and Michaels scores.
Look at this! Oh,
the Nipper!
Like a pimple on prom night! Shawn Michaels pops up! And down goes Shane McMahon!
In front of the atomic rock on the right hand, Michaels building momentum before this sold-out crowd tonight in Detroit.
No!
The boy wonder Shane McMahon is in big trouble.
Big trouble is an understatement. This could do it right here.
Michaels takes a chance. Really?
Yes!
Michaels driving the elbow into the affluent black heart of Shane McMahon.
And now we may see and hear that patented chin music.
It'll be a Motown sound for Shawn Michaels as the man tunes up.
And I'll get you some!
Disqualifications. Mr. McMahon's demon seed was about to be pinned by Shawn Michaels.
Well, I think Shawn Michaels has just snapped.
He's begging Shawn Michaels not to accost him, not to hurt him.
Mr. McMahon better beg.
Oh, low blow. The low blow by Shane McMahon. And now, Mr. McMahon was begging for mercy.
Anyway, what's McMahon instructing his son to do now? Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Wait a minute. The sharpshooter replied.
Bring the baton. Submission, Shane McMahon. Stay. Winner by submission, Shane McMahon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by submission, Shane McMahon.
Oh, what the hell is that? McMahon screws Bret Hart in 97, and now we got to relive it here. The McMahons have just screwed Shawn Michaels.
I cannot believe this. Did you see Shawn Michaels submit?
Shawn Michaels did not submit. The McMahons have screwed Shawn Michaels. Michaels has been castrated of his dignity at the hands of the diabolical McMahons. These tortured souls, these McMahons are going to pay, and it could happen at WrestleMania.
Quite frankly, WrestleMania was one of my great creations, but not my greatest, you see? Mike.
Oh, this is getting ridiculous.
Nothing like a little Southern hospitality, huh? Real class group here in Memphis. See, before I was so rudely interrupted, my greatest creation is not WrestleMania. My greatest creation is you, Shane, you and your sister, Stephanie.
Oh, boy. Really?
You know, you never told me that.
Oh, look at this. This is touching.
Yeah, some people might find this nauseating. Well,
several months ago, when Shawn Michaels disrespected me and refused to retire as scheduled, I vowed then to make Shawn Michaels' life a living hell. And quite frankly, I personally put Shawn Michaels on the highway to hell. On that highway to hell, there have been several stops along the way. One comes to mind, particularly dear to my heart. Actually, not so much dear to my heart as it is dear to another portion of my anatomy. When Shawn Michaels became a certified member of the Mr. McMahon Kiss My Ass Club.
It's a rare group. Very unique to be a part of that club.
There were several stops as well. Marty Jannetty, Michael's former tag team partner and longtime friend, when I refused to hire him. And then, oh, this was a good one. Remember to stop along that highway when in this very ring, Shawn Michaels was publicly humiliated. He had to give us a urine specimen in this very ring for a drug test. That was humiliating.
Yeah, he gave and then Michaels,
a couple of other stops, he had to face the Spirit Squad, not once, but twice, one of them in a steel cage match. And there were some other stops along the way, but unquestionably, the latest one was when my son Shane, last Saturday night, made Shawn Michaels submit from the sharpshooter. And make no mistake about it, my son Shane did not screw Shawn Michaels. I did not screw Shawn Michaels.
Oh, hell you didn't. Oh.
Just for the record, Shawn Michaels screwed Shawn Michaels.
There you go.
And you know, this highway to hell's leading to WrestleMania, where Michaels is gonna reach a dead end. Yeah, WrestleMania, Michaels has had many great moments, like when he won the title for the first time, like when he returned to WrestleMania after that, what we thought was going to be a career-ending back injury. But this WrestleMania will be a turning point for Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is not only going to hit a dead end, Shawn Michaels will crash at this year's WrestleMania. And when Michaels crashes, he will once again become what he was once before a long time ago. Michaels will be nothing more than a morally bankrupt, miserable bastard.
Oh. And that's exactly what he was.
And then all that Shawn Michaels holds so dear, his faith, his family, his friends, and all of his fans all over the world, every damn one of you will be contaminated. Contaminated because the victor of the match at WrestleMania will be the chairman of the board, will be Vincent Kennedy McMahon.
We'll find out in less than 2 weeks at WrestleMania, but Shawn Michaels did not tap out Saturday night.
By the way, Michaels, if you're thinking that your match with me at WrestleMania is gonna be a normal match, think again. Your match with me now, Michaels, is no holds barred.
Oh, boy.
I love it.
You inspired that one, by the way, Shane.
Yeah.
And by the way, when I mentioned that highway to hell, there's another stop. Damn, there's another stop of the highway to hell right here tonight.
Shocking.
And that stop of the highway to hell is going to see Shawn Michaels compete one-on-one with the game, Triple H.
That should be a classic here tonight.
Now strike up the band. Let's get this party rolling again.
Styles, you must forget
the kind of condition that Shawn Michaels must be in. That's not going to be a classic. Well, it's going to be a ball.
Let's let the Saints go marching out. It's about time now. I think we've seen and heard enough.
Let me say something here. You kicked a couple of my balloons on the way out. I don't like that. Well, what I don't like even more, I don't like being interrupted out here. So unless you're going to join the celebration with my son Shane, I would suggest you take your leave.
Who do you think you are? Huh? You come down here walking, who do you think you are? You don't make decisions around here. You know who makes decisions around here? That's it, the McMahons. So John, as my dad was saying, we can do this the easy way, or we can do this the hard way. The easy way is, John, why don't you see your little butt back down that aisle where you came from?
That's good stuff.
Or we can do this the hard way, where I can beat you down where you stand, just like I did HBK.
Oh, I'd buy a ticket to that match.
You know what? I think Shane McMahon is starting to believe.
Wait just a minute. I'm going to help you out tonight, Cena. I may even save your ass, Cena.
Hang on, Shane.
I don't want Shane to beat your ass out here right now. And I'm saving myself for Shawn Michaels. Otherwise, I might do it. I'll tell you what. Shut up! Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna give you what you want. You want Triple H? You got him. You got him right here tonight.
What?
Except it's not gonna be single competition. No, no, no. You got yourself a tag team partner. It's John Cena and the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels together.
That's big. I like that team.
That's huge.
And your opponents? Well, one of your opponents will be the game Triple H, and the other will be a man teaming up with Triple H for the very first time. My son, Shane!
Wow!
Now, hit the music. Let's go. Strike up the band, baby.
Yeah, hit the
music. Party on the way.
You know, funny, Shane McMahon doesn't seem all that enthused right now, does he?
You know what? Joey, I'll celebrate along with this. This is great news. Look at Shane. Look at his face.
Hey, that's silent confidence, fellas. You know that. Shane McMahon has never backed down from a fight. Tonight, he's not going to start.
Well, he's not going to back down, but I bet he wishes he could back out.
Mr. McMahon is dancing. Shane McMahon is not the WWE Champion. John Cena and Shawn Michaels to take on the game Triple H. And Shane McMahon here tonight live on Raw.
Look at Shane's face.
Look at
Shane McMahon, what a right hand.
Stop it down. Damn it, stop this match right now.
What?
What?
Stop the match? What are you talking about?
Did we even start?
You saw what I saw. It's about time people started paying attention to the rules and regulations. Cena just used a clenched fist. He is disqualified. This match is over.
You know, that's a great point.
Oh,
a
stop. Great point. Wait,
the winners of the match are Triple H and Shane McMahon, I would suggest. Security, you keep that animal at bay. I need a couple of you to come over here and escort Mr. Cena out of this arena right now.
Coach, everyone, hey. This is exactly what took place 2 nights ago on Saturday Night Main
Let's
Event.
Let's go, Mr. Cena. I don't think you want to risk not going to WrestleMania. I don't think you want to risk getting your title stripped from you. So I would suggest you take your leave.
King, if John Cena would follow the rules.
Oh, give me a break.
A close
fist. If you even think about interfering in my activities later on tonight, there'll be hell to pay. Now then, what we are going to have is more action here tonight.
What?
I know what I'm doing, all right? So tonight there's going to be a handicap match. Triple H and Shane McMahon versus Shawn Michaels. Now ring the damn bell. Get him in here and ring the bell.
Yeah, ring the bell.
Throw him in.
So
throw his ass in the ring.
So, Coach, you don't think the McMahons are abusing their power now? You don't think they're screwing Shawn Michaels here tonight?
Of course they are.
They just want the competitors to follow the rules.
Now throw him in.
Shawn Michaels wide open, held by security, and Triple H just picks his shot.
And Shane O'Mac is just waiting
for
the heartbreak
kick. Now ring the bell, ref.
Now what? Triple H directing traffic in there now, telling Shane to go to the top rope.
What chance did any one man have against the game and Shane McMahon? Look at this.
Hey,
it's John Cena. John Cena, the WWE Champion, is back.
John Cena was told not to interfere.
Low blow by Shawn Michaels on the game.
What the hell is John Cena doing out here?
He's disobeying orders.
That's exactly what he's doing.
Well, no one else is willing to do it. Oh, my God, right in front of us. Security, all hell is broken loose in the center of the ring.
Look at this.
Fists are flying everywhere. John Cena and Shawn Michaels.
Vince McMahon and Shane McMahon trying to beat it out of here. All his security forces being decimated.
There are bodies flying everywhere.
Yeah. And landing right in front of us.
Oh,
sweet sheet music flying right now. F you.
What the hell just happened?
Hey. Hey, John Cena, I said there was gonna be hell to pay, and damn it, there will be. Next week, Cena, you're gonna go one-on-one with me.
What?
With the chairman?
Vince McMahon, one-on-one with John Cena next week?
He just did.
Shawn Michaels did. Oh, no.
That is disgraceful. Get him, Gabe. Go ahead.
Pedigree by the Gabe.
Hey, Styles, count on top.
Nobody gets up from the pedigree, and the Gabe got all of that one. Shawn Michaels driven face first into the canvas.
Shawn Michaels just got what he deserved. You hit the bus, you got to pay.
Shawn Michaels certainly fired the opening salvo heading into this Sunday night.
Wait. What is going on now?
Look like it's going on now.
It's a very unhappy chair. That's what's going on.
What is he doing in the ring?
Michaels is helpless. Shawn Michaels is helpless. He's defenseless.
What's going
on? Oh, baby.
Oh,
it's
God.
The great equalizer.
Wait a minute. It's a sledgehammer. Call him whatever you want, Coach.
Yeah, Jack Patton, get out of the way, son.
Look at Vince McMahon holding Shawn Michaels down.
He's defenseless. Michaels wide open.
Wait a second.
The champ is here. John Cena is here.
Cena was smart. He turned around and go right back up the ramp.
John Cena's not going anywhere. Except right into Triple H's face.
There are some fights that you gotta back down from. And Cena wants a piece of that.
Cena doesn't back down from fights, Coach.
Whoa. What is going on here? Look at this.
Hey, game, easy.
Triple H just dropped his hammer.
To
throw down that sledgehammer. WrestleMania, this is your preview this Sunday night. The WWE Championship is on the line. And is that what's in store for the game this Sunday night? Let's take a look at what just happened the break on WWE.com Unlimited.
Huge news.
I'll tell you what's going to happen out there. And what's going to happen out there? When I go one-on-one with John Cena, he can have Shawn Michaels in his corner. Because I'm going to have Triple H in mine.
And screaming, Shawn Michaels got his wrist up there, so referee Mike Chioda can handcuff him to the bottom rope as well. And apparently now, indeed, Mr. McMahon actually wants to go one-on-one with John Cena.
The referee, ring the bell.
He said that a little bit more.
Yeah, I can read it. Look at this.
I never called a Mr. McMahon match before. So Mr. McMahon wants to go one-on-one with John Cena, and
he asked for this match last week.
because Johnson can interrupt it. Shawn Michaels right on the highway to hell.
Hey, chairman's not ready yet. The chairman will be ready when the chairman is ready.
We have to do everything on the chairman's time.
No, don't jump the gun. Don't jump the gun.
Is the chairman, Mr. McMahon, ready to take on Shawn Michaels this Sunday night at WrestleMania?
He certainly doesn't seem ready to take on John Cena right here.
Yes, please, give it John Cena a break.
Oh, here they go. They locked up. Look at the strength. It's literally a test of strength here.
John Cena couldn't even move the chairman.
I'll tell you something, I'm a little bit impressed right here.
I'm a lot impressed.
Crowd solidly behind the WWE Champion, John Cena, no shock there. Mr. McMahon's only fan is sitting next to us, King.
Well, Triple H is also over there, handcuffed.
Yeah, I don't know if he's really a fan, though.
Got these two guys, it's like two bulls in there, testing each other's strength.
Comes up even, pretty much again.
I don't think Cena ever faced anybody like this at the Hard Knocks gym. Back up in Massachusetts.
There's a little bit of preening and posturing right here. Uh-oh. Headlock by Mr. McMahon.
He's got the strength to cut off the windpipe.
Somebody call Ripley's. Look at the size of the chest. Look at the arm. Look at the crash.
Call Ripley's. Mr. McMahon has the advantage here.
Now Cena can't even breathe.
Wait a minute. John Cena's not going to stay in this for very long.
Wait a minute. Where's the strength? Mr. McMahon being out muscle.
Yes, he is. Look at Mr. McMahon's face. He's
away.
McMahon is down, Mr. McMahon is down, and he's shocked. He can't believe it.
I think Cena pulled his hair.
Pulled his hair?
The chairman would never just fall down.
Look at this.
Imagine an elite athlete.
He's bleeding, Mr.
McMahon.
He's
bleeding from his ear.
He knows that,
right here.
Come on.
McMahon wants just an old-fashioned test of strength here.
He wants to lace up those fingers.
Ah! Oh.
Got the old Greco-Roman knuckle lock.
Look at this. Come on, boss, go ahead. It's like moving a wall, and I'm not talking about Cena.
Mr. McMahon's face, look at the power of Mr. McMahon.
And look at this, look at the eyes.
Come on, baby, come on, boss, I know you can do it.
Uh-oh. Here comes the WWE Champion, Mr. McMahon. Can't believe it, down he goes.
Mr. McMahon on his knees. He can't believe it. He's in a lot of pain, coach. You got to break the hold.
Or you get your fingers broken.
Hey, Keanu, break the hold.
Why? Why does he have to break the hold? They're not in the ropes.
John Cena may break Mr. McMahon's fingers.
Mr. McMahon will have to wrestle Shawn Michaels this Sunday at WrestleMania with his hands
on. Oh, hey, what about
that? That was blatant. Come on.
He just kicked the man right in. Are you allowed to disqualify the chairman?
Yeah, blatant disqualification. Referee Mike Keanu had a call for the belt. Is that the handcuff key? Yeah, that's the handcuff key.
What does he mean? What's he gonna do here? Wait a minute.
I think he's gonna do. He's gonna hand the handcuff key to Triple H, but not Shawn Michaels.
Well, the ref's got a key.
Fellas, I'll go ahead and say it. Triple H is loose.
Come on, Jim.
Come on, ref.
And Shawn Michaels is the proverbial sitting duck, handcuffed to the bottom rope.
Triple H is loose. And he's got the great equalizer.
Come on, somebody's got to do something about this.
Well, don't worry, Triple H is going to.
Shawn Michaels is hopeless on the outside. All he can do is watch the WWE Champion back to his feet.
Here we go.
Damn it, sledgehammer right to the face of the WWE Champion.
That's the number one contender. Just hit a home run straight out of Nebraska.
And Shawn Michaels is completely helpless to help the WWE Champion.
And look at the glee, the joy on the face of Vince McMahon. He's like obsessed, he's possessed.
Mr. McMahon promised Shawn Michaels one more stop on the highway to hell to WrestleMania this Sunday night. Oh, no, he delivered. No. And John Cena was a speed bump on that highway to hell.
And all the Heartbreak Kid can do is stand there and look and do nothing.
6 days before WrestleMania, the sledgehammer to the head of the WWE Champion has busted John Cena wide open. The game just taunting Shawn Michaels with that handcuff key. Nowhere for Michaels to go.
Come on. He's got it. He's got it.
Guys, this all could have been avoided. It all could have been avoided.
Oh, no, this was well laid out and pre-planned.
Oh, look, he's tripped. Mr. McMahon's got a chair. Shawn Michaels is he's tripped.
Oh, no.
Sledgehammer to the midsection. Shawn Michaels. Oh. Wide open for Mr. McMahon and that steel chin. Damn it.
Good grief.
You guys can say.
Yeah, you guys should be real proud of yourselves. Triple H.
I'm proud of him. I couldn't be any happier.
And Triple H and Mr. McMahon have succeeded in blooding both the WWE Champion John Cena and the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels.
I tried to tell you, John Cena, Shawn Michaels have asked for everything that they have received. And this Sunday, Triple H is going to receive the WWE Championship.
Well, there's going to be some receiving this Sunday, but don't count out Shawn Michaels and John Cena. McMahon, the game, they may receive the
King. They're dead. They're gone. They're history.
Oh, yeah, right.
Triple H is going to be the 11th time WWE champ.
Can Shawn Michaels pull himself together in just 6 days? Can he recover?
Coach, I want you to watch this again. Watch what we've seen tonight. Yeah, you've seen this, first of all, a blatant low blow, that kick. And then look at that. Yeah, the game is real tough with a sledgehammer. The sledgehammer right to the head.
All along, Mr. McMahon held the key to Shawn Michaels' future. And he used it to untuck Triple H.
And what about this? Sledgehammer.
Rosy roads for them are coming to an end because of those two men right there.
Can John Cena pull himself together and fight back the challenge of Triple H? Can Shawn Michaels recover and take on Mr. McMahon? We'll find out this Sunday night at WrestleMania.